How did Dio survive the events of Phantom Blood? Was it pure intelligence? Was it? Well, let's find out. Okay, guys, so today we're going to be talking about Dio and how he survived the events of Phantom Blood. Now, obviously, this is quite different from the discussions of the main channel, so I just kind of wanted to discuss JoJo's Bizarre Adventures because I love the series, and this was something that's kind of been bothering me for a while. So, let's get into it. Now, the first theory is that Dio had placed two coffins onto the ship. Now, I can tell you this much, Dio is not the type of man to think that far ahead. He is too cocky, especially in part one, to think of anything that elaborate. He had placed one coffin into the ship, and I highly doubt that there was another. So, when this happened, if this were to happen, that would mean there's two different coffins, but that can't really happen because Dio's not that smart. Plus, other people would say that it's Wang Chen's coffin, but when the coffin arises in part 3, you can clearly see that it says Dio on it. So, I don't think it's Wang Chen's just because Dio wouldn't write his name for that, and it just wouldn't make any sense for namesake, I guess. So I'm gonna toss that one out the window. Upon that, plus nothing was ever mentioned of a second coffin by Dio. He had specifically said one that he himself would survive in, but that coffin was taken by Rina. So that theory is out the window. Now the next theory is to do with Dio and Rina being in the same coffin, but there being two different compartments. Now for this, it kind of gets a bit tricky, but if you pay close attention, like if you pay very close attention, you can see that there's some difference in the part 1 coffin and the part 3 coffin. The difference being, in part 1, there's nothing written on the coffin, and then when the coffin comes up in part 3, it has Dio engraved in it. So that in itself concludes that there is no way it was the same coffin with two different compartments, even though the anime tried to play that off. Bullshit. Okay, so the next theory is that when Rina was rescued in the coffin, that Dio then got into the coffin and then he waited for however long, which was 100 years, which is also bullshit, just because if you think about it, the ship gets sunk. Okay, then when the ship sinks, Irina is already on top of the water, and she's being flown by the current of the ocean, right? So that takes her away, possibly to shore, right? Well, Dio's still at the bottom of the ocean. No way he's keeping up with the coffin just due to the fact that sunlight or sunrise is going to happen at some point. So there's no way that's going to happen. So think about it like this. A ship sinks, then a coffin goes off, perhaps, let's say for now, an example, a linear path in the water. It goes far away, hundreds or several thousands of miles away from the ship wreckage, right? So there's no way that's possible. Now, I have a conclusion, and I'll give my reasons for why I think it happened. Now, this is that Araki had initially decided that part 1 would be Dio's ending with Jonathan's death, but then in part 3 he kind of decided, hey, I'll bring him back, and he decided to retcon the ending of part 1, which can kind of be considered not by complete means of a retcon, but obviously I believe it was Dio's death being retconned, because initially that looks like Jonathan and Dio die as one, hence their relationship being bizarre. So there's that, but I believe that is the case of a continuity error, or rather a retcon, because Araki in an interview states that he does believe that his work for Phantom Blood wasn't his best writing ever. So that kind of says, hey, I know I messed up there. So they kind of he himself admitted to it, and I believe that was a retcon, but I don't think there is any other popular theories as these three, so I kind of believe that serves the purpose of the discussion. Now, obviously, I love part three, but this was kind of bothering me as, hey, how did you survive that ending in part one, right? But if it had... This is why it's called JoJo's Bizarre Adventures. This is what makes it truly bizarre. Stuff like this. But yeah, Gyo is the greatest villain of JoJo, in my opinion at least. Let me know what you think in the comment section below. Have a great day, guys.